introduce Miguette from Iowa State University. He's going to speak about an examination of safety of signalized intersections in consideration of nearby access points. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My name is Mugat Usama Mugat Jahari. I'm a second year master's student from Iowa State University. So this morning I'll be presenting a research topic called examining the safety impacts of driveway proximity to signalized intersection. So this is the outline of this presentation. So I will start with a brief introduction and the objective of this study and some data collection that we did. And I will go through to the method that we use in this analysis, and I will talk about the result, and I will end this presentation with the conclusion and some recommendations. So first of all, what is access point? So based on highway capacity manual, access point can be defined as any intersection, driveway, or median opening that allows vehicle to gain access on the right hand side. And if the access point is on the left hand side, it's considered as an access point if it affects the traffic flow on the opposite direction. So basically, access there are several types of access points that we encounter every day. For example, intersection, alleys, driveway, median opening, field access, and many more. So basically, these access points, so managing these access points is very important in order to avoid unnecessary situations. For example, delay in travel time, increase in number of crashes being observed, and many more. So that's why most of the state in this country already have access management guidance in order to control the manner in which people gain access to. So access management based on Institute of Transportation Engineers, they define access management as a program to ensure the roadway system will operate safely and efficiently while meeting the needs of adjacent land along the roadway. So basically, access management is very important in facilitating the safety and operation of the roadway, and that is why state and local government use this guidance to control the manner of vehicle gain access to and from the major roadway to all types of access. So basically, good access management will result in several positive impacts towards safety and operation of the roadway. So the first one, it will increase the travel speed of the vehicle, it will reduce the number of crashes along the roadway, and it will increase the capacity of the roadway, and also it will reduce the delay, which eventually decrease the travel time. So those positive impact can be achieved by applying several techniques towards the roadway system. For example, by constructing a median, it will eliminate some of the conflict points. By reducing access point density, increasing the distance between two intersections, particularly signalized intersections, and lastly limiting the distance between intersection and first access point, which is the point that I'm going to talk about in this presentation. So, locating this access point is very crucial. So if these access points are located at the place that are they are shouldn't be, so it will create a conflict between vehicles and even with the pedestrian and bicyclists. So basically, this conflict occurs when the vehicle trying to make a left turn movement from major road into the access point or from any access point into the major road. So basically, there are two types of crashes that are commonly associated with this location or situation. For example, rear end crashes and right angle crashes. So basically, throughout the years, there has been a lot of research that has been done on access management. So Avalar in 2013 found that crash rate increased when total number of access point or access point density increased. Other than that, Berman found that driveway density, unsignalized density, and the type of median have a significant correlation with crash frequency. And Dr. Junior mentioned that by doubling the number of access points, it will increase the number of crashes between 20 to 40%. However, most of the previous research was done based on midpoint, mid-block access point, and further examination on access point near signalized intersection need to be done. So that's why the objective of this study was to determine the safety impacts of driveway near signalized intersections. And we used 12 different buffer distance from the center of intersection, which between 50 to 300 feet, with the increment of 50 feet on the primary road network. So to accomplish this study, several data were integrated. So for the first one is IoT intersection database. So we use this database to obtain our 415 sample of signalized intersection within urban area in Iowa State, and we use this database to obtain our type of intersection control and number of nodes present. So the second one is IoT information management system, which also known as TIMS. So basically, this file contains roadway information such as traffic information, roadway characteristics. So we use this file to get like AADT, number of lanes, posted speed. We also did some manual data collection. So for the first one, we used a process called SRP digitizing using ArcGIS. So basically, we manually collect all access points within the static buffer. So we found that there's a driveway, unsignalized intersection, and signalized intersection within 600 feet buffer. And we also determined the type of land development around our intersection using satellite imagery. So basically, we found that there are two types of land development within urban area, which is residential and commercial area. So basically, this is an example of intersection with several access points near to it. So basically, we had manually collect all these access points within 600 feet. And lastly, we use IoT intersection, IoT crash database. So basically, this database we use 5 years of crash data from 2011 to 2015. Some filtration was done in order to obtain the final data set. So basically, we first filter it into just urban area, and then we narrow it down to just crash data on our IoT jurisdiction, which is considered as primary road in the data set. And lastly, we filter it into type of roadway junction which the crash occurred. As I mentioned before, we use special distance from center of intersection, so basically it's from 50 to 600 feet buffer radius with the increment of 50 feet interval. So this is the summary data for all the predictive variables that might affect the number of crashes. So as you can see here, most of the variables here we have both for major and minor roads. So basically, this road were determined based on the number of AADT. So whichever road that has higher AADT, will be considered as a major road, and the smaller one is considered as minor road. So as you can see, both AADT on major and minor road has a very huge range here. One possible reason is that part of our intersection is located in residential area, about 19% of it is in this area. And about 80% of our intersection is four-lane, and the rest is three-lane intersection. So this is the summary table for number of driveway within the study buffer. As you can see, as you increase the buffer distance, the maximum number of driveway will also increase, same as the mean value of each predictive variables here. So for the methodology, the safety analysis that we did is so we used 415 signalized intersections using different buffer radii, and we determine how present and absent of driveway influence the crash rate based on time. So basically, we differentiate models that use total crashes against models that use driveway related crashes or intersection related crashes. So the method that we used in this study was negative binomial regression model in order to predict the number of crashes. So basically, we use this model because of the dispersion of the crash data, and since the crash data usually associate with the discrete, non-negative, and random, so that's why we use this model. So basically lambda I here represent the predicted number of crashes for intersection I over the time period. And beta n is the parameter estimate that we get from the regression model, and xn is the predicted variables that we think that might affect the number of crashes, for example, traffic volume, cross-sectional characteristics, and number of traffic. And the exponential epsilon is the gamma distributed with mean equal to 1 and variance of alpha. There were three types of crashes that were analyzed in this study. And the first one is drive-related crashes, which we only include crashes that occur near driveway. And second one is we include intersection-related crashes. And the last one is the total crashes, which we include all type of crashes that occur within the study buffer on the primary road network. So for the purpose of this presentation, I will only show 300 feet buffer to differentiate all these three. So the first one is driveway related crashes on a primary road network with a 300 feet buffer distance. So basically from this model, as you can see, all the predicted variables have a positive estimate, which associate with increasing the number of crashes. So for example, as you can see the number of driveways here, the coefficient is 0.255, which can be interpreted as every additional number of driveway within 300 feet buffer, you will be expected to see about 29% increase in number of crashes. Moving to the next one, this is the model that we use using driveway and intersection related crashes. So basically, these models also have all the predictive variables have positive estimate, which same as previous one associated with increasing number of crashes. But however, if you can see here, the estimate coefficient for number of driveways here has become smaller. One of the possible reasons is that the previous model we used only driveway-related crashes, and this one we used intersection. We include intersection-related crashes and during predicting the number of crashes, there might be other predictors associated with intersection that were not included when we estimating the number of crashes. And that's why we see much smaller value of the estimate coefficient here. And the last one is total crashes using 300 feet within the study buffer. So basically, this model also have positive estimate. And this model have approximately the same estimate for all the predictive variables as this model. And to interpret this coefficient, it can be interpreted as every additional number of driveway, you will expect to see about 2.9% increase in number of crashes. So, since our study is to determine different effect of number of driveway based on different buffer distance. So basically, we estimate to have different safety performance functions using total crashes from 50 to 600 feet buffer. So if you can focus on just number of driveway here, so this slide is shown for 350 and to 600 feet buffer. So basically, as you reduce the buffer distance, the estimate coefficient here will increase. Same goes for 50 to 300 feet buffer distance. As you decrease your buffer distance from 300 to 50 feet, the estimate coefficient will also increase. So basically, it can be said that as you decrease the buffer distance, the number of crashes will be expected to be higher due to the close vicinity of the accessible towards the signalized intersection. So basically, this table, I just want to show the trend in increasing value of estimate coefficient for each buffer distance. So basically, as you can see here, as you reduce the buffer distance from 600 feet, the estimate coefficient will information based on different gravity counts when we hold other variable constants. So basically all these lines represent the safety performance function that I showed you before. And from this graph, you can see that when you increase the buffer distance from center of signalized intersection, the slope of each graph will become flatter, which means the effect of driveways decrease as you increase the buffer distance. And as the conclusion, access point density has shown a significant effect on various types of crashes when you approach signalized intersections, and crashes consistently increase with the frequency of driving near signalized intersection, regardless of buffer distance. And crash rate tend to be highest when driving were in close proximity to signalized intersection, particularly in between 50 to 100 feet buffer radius. And for the future research, I would like to run a model based on crash severity or injury to see what type of crashes give more severe injury to the passenger, and also more detailed information about access point may provide refined guidelines. For example, number of volume generated from each access point, turning movement available from each access point, and the purpose of each driveway, whether it's, for example, for gas station, shopping center, restaurant, and so on. So this is the references that we use in this presentation, in this study. And I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge all the co-authors in this paper, Trevor Kirsch, Bahar, Dr. Timothy Barrett, Dr. Peter Severlion, and thank you. I will answer any question.
No questions?